to investigate. There didn't appear to be any signs of forced entry. When we went into the...
Saw the victim dead on the floor.
Began to go, identifying him as a suspect.
Hey, we appreciate you coming here.
I didn't do this.
David Fust was adamant that he had absolutely nothing to do with the murder of his wife.
Who do you think
did? But he thinks he knows who does.
He began to talk about Margaret and Melissa. He goes into detail about the estate, about the dispute.
He said that he had been summoned away from the house by them.
David called.
The way he...
As police continue the interview, they received word that Kelly's car has been located. Abandoned.
They began to finger point, and their stories began to change because they became unsure of what the other partner was telling the other detectives.
Yeah, Margaret was with me. We went out for breakfast.
I was having coffee. Tell.
Hello?
Yeah. I met Joel for breakfast.
The interviews tended to go. He never made any type of immediate admission about having been involved in the case.
He didn't do any...
Detectives confront them over their inconsistencies with their stories. They don't a lesser charge. Prosecutors give in.
Life was more paramount.
To bolster their case against Joel, prosecutors also him. They will drop the murder charges against her. Joel insists he didn't murder Kelly Fuss, and some may be innocent.
No. 30 stab wounds to